I was a big fan of that. Ready to fish. Got a good backdrop of all the foliage today.
So here we are, we're at Butterfield Pond here in Wilmot, right on the edge of the Guile State Forest, and this is one of the remote ponds for fishing game filled with brook trout, and this is fall fishing, and so it's a little bit different because the brook trout at this point in the season are starting to spawn, and so we're going to be looking for some gravel beds that we might find some fish around those areas. Typically, they're very aggressive at this point in time. With pond fishing, it's not like fishing a stream. The fish cruise all over the pond. So the presentation's a little bit different to these fish. In the summer in a pond like this, you'd want to locate the spring and fish the spring area. At this point, the water's pretty cold. I didn't take the temperature, but it all bodes well for fall fishing. Oh, Chuck's got one.
I just went to the that blood red golden retriever I was telling you about.
The old adage, dark fly, dark day, bright fly, bright day. And I'm fishing something that, I'm fishing a taboo caddis emerger. I'm using a feather from a hewing hen. When I learned to tie flies when I was growing up, I probably was in fourth or fifth grade. I don't think I've ever bought any unless it was a collector fly. There was a box of fly tying equipment, and I started fooling around with it, and I think there was some directions with it, and probably didn't read the directions very well, but I was able to tie a couple flies, and then from there it took off.
Sure is a pretty time of year to be on the water, though. There he is. He's a feisty little bunch. This is a little male, too.
Float tube fishing is kind of a hidden jewel. It's an underutilized way of fishing. A lot of people are intimidated by it, but, you know, waders, wading boots, the tube and some fins and a good PFD and you're good to go.